Dear students, today I will discuss about the oncology, that is the study of tumors. Before proceeding into the proper tumors description, we should know about the growth and differentiation. These are two important characteristics of the tumors. The growth is increase in volume through formation of new protoplasm within cell or cells with or without of cell division. Growth is increase in volume through formation of protoplasm within cells or cell with or without cell division. The second point is differentiation. As I have discussed previously also, the differentiation is derivation of different cell types with a specialized structure and function from a common ancestral type. That is, embryological development is an exercise in differentiation. That is, differentiation is a derivation of different cell types with a specialized structure and function from a common ancestral cell. That is, embryological development is an exercise in differentiation. Now coming to disturbance of the growth. The disturbance of the growth has been divided into developmental and acquired. The development defect are agenesis. That is, the organ has not formed. Agenesis, without genesis. That is, organ has not formed or tissue has not formed. Then aplasia, the tissue has formed or organ has formed, but in the form of rudimentary analogy. Aplasia, the organ has formed, but in the form of rudimentary analogy. Then hypoplasia, the organ is not fully developed. It is underdeveloped. So hypo means less and plasia means formation. The tissue is underdeveloped or incomplete development of the organ. Then some muscular dystrophy also comes in this category, developmental defects. Now acquired, it is also, that has been taught in your cellular adaptations also. The acquired developmental disturbance of growth has been categorized into quantitative and qualitative change. The quantitative change are decreased growth. The quantitative change are decreased growth, like atrophy and dystrophy. Atrophy are brown atrophy of the heart, and dystrophy, corneal dystrophy, retinal dystrophy, conal dystrophy, myotonic dystrophy, and lipodystrophy of the intestinal lipodystrophy. Then increased growth in the form of hypertrophy and hyperplasia. That has been discussed by Dr. Ramesh Chandra in detail. Hypertrophy is increase in volume through increase in the size of the cell, and hyperplasia is increase in the volume of the cell through increased proliferation, multiplication of the cell. That is, cell number is increased. The example of cardiac hypertrophy are cardiac hypertrophy. Isolated hypertrophy of cardiac muscles occurs. That is, increased in the volume through increased formation of protoplasm without division of the cell. Then qualitative aberrations or qualitative change, that is, abnormalities of cellular differentiation. Here abnormalities quantitative are abnormality of cellular growth, decreased growth, increased growth, atrophy, increased hypertrophy, hyperplasia. Then qualitative abnormalities of cellular differentiation in the form of metaplasia, dysplasia, anaplasia, neoplasia. So these four forms are qualitative abnormalities of differentiation, cellular differentiation: metaplasia, dysplasia, anaplasia, and neoplasia. Then difference: metaplasia, dysplasia, must have been taught by Dr. Ramesh Chandra. So the metaplasia is transformation of one type of differentiated tissue into another type of differentiated tissue is called metaplasia. Metaplasia is transformation of one type of differentiated tissue into another type of differentiated tissue in response to persistent injury. The dysplasia, disordered growth or disordered differentiation, that is disordered growth, abnormalities in size and shape and organization of the cells due to chronic irritation or inflammation may progress to neoplasm or revert to normal if the stimuli are removed or stress is removed. And anaplasia is lack of differentiation. Anaplasia is lack of differentiation. I have told you previously in the previous slide that differentiation, abnormalities of differentiation are metaplasia, dysplasia, anaplasia and neoplasia. So anaplasia is lack of differentiation. Malignant transformation of cells, autonomous or continue to proliferate even after removal of the stimuli or initiator. Examples are squamous metaplasia in a smoking lung, in a smoking bronchi. The transformation of glandular epithelium, columnar epithelium into a squamous epithelium due to irritation by the smoke. Similarly, transformers of a squamous cell of the esophagus into intestinal cells, that is intestinalization of the esophagus, it is a pre-malignant or malignant conditions called Barrett's esophagus. Then cervical intraepithelial neoplasia. Cervical intraepithelium neoplasia are example previously British nomenclature are dysplasia, mild dysplasia, moderate dysplasia and severe dysplasia. An American system or Latin system is cervical intraepithelial neoplasm, cervical intraepithelial neoplasm type 2 and cervical intraneoplasm type 3. In cervical mild dysplasia or cervical intraepithelial neoplasm type 1 are the abnormalities are in the 1/3 portion in the basal layer. In the moderate type of dysplasia or seen cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, the abnormalities are up to lower 2/3. And severe type of dysplasia, that is cervical intraepithelial neoplasia type 3, is whole epidermis is involved. That is whole, not 2/3, but 3/3, whole epidermis is replaced by abnormal cells. But the it is called intraepithelial neoplasia. Neoplasia is within the cells, but there is no invasion. The neoplasia is confined to epithelial cells only. And the anaplasia are examples are carcinoma and sarcoma. Cancer of the epithelium is carcinoma. Cancer of mesenchymal tissue, connective tissue is called sarcoma. Then examples, then reversibility. The metaplasia, dysplasia are reversible. That is CIN1 and CIN2, cervical epithelial neoplasia 1 and 2 are reversible. Whereas the anaplasia, that is cervical epithelial neoplasm type 3 or anaplastic differentiations are irreversible. Then cell polarity is normal, it is lost in dysplasia, it is lost in anaplasia. The nuclear cytoplasmic ratio, it is normal in case of metaplasia, it is increased in case of dysplasia, and nuclear cytoplasmic ratio is increased in case of anaplasia also. Then pleomorphism, the pleomorphism is absent in metaplasia, in dysplasia, pleomorphism is mild, and in anaplasia, it is severe or high grade of pleomorphism is there. The vocabulary, hyperplasia, increase in number of cells, hypertrophy, increase in the size of the cells, dysplasia, disordered growth or disordered proliferation, then neoplasia, abnormal new growth, then anaplasia, lack of differentiation, and tumor, originally meant for any swelling, like swelling by inflammation, hematoma and tumor also. So this tumor is was baked up initially for inflammatory swelling, hematoma, and neoplasia as well. So, and metastasis growth of at a distant site. Then oncology. Oncos means tumor, and logos means discourse or a study. Oncology is the scientific study of the tumor or neoplasm is called oncology. Scientific study of the tumor or neoplasm is called oncology. Tumor, localized swelling or lump like hematoma, inflammatory swelling or neoplasm, as I told you, neoplasm. Neo means new, plasm means a thing formed. That is new growth or new kind of growth is called neoplasm. And neoplasia, the underlying pathological process in the formation of neoplasm. That is, neoplasia is a pathological process underlying the formation of new growth or neoplasm is called neoplasia. But today, tumors or neoplasm are used synonymously. But conventionally, tumor is restricted to a specific kind of growth, that is neoplasm. The definition of the neoplasm, most important is Willis. And when you will be asked in the university question or in the internal examination, you have to tell about the Willis definition. But two definitions are also there, Powell White and Ewing's definition. Ewing's definition, a mass of cell or tissue or organs resembling those normally present in the body but arranged atypically, that grows at the expense of organism without subserving any useful purpose. But this Powell's definition fails to distinguish tumor from the malformation. Powell's definition, again I repeat, is a mass of cell or tissue or organs resembling those normally present in the body but arranged atypically, which grows at the expense of organism without subserving any useful function to the organism therein, but fails to distinguish tumor from the malformation. Ewing's definition of the tumor or neoplasm is an autonomous new growth of tissue but not regulated by external signal. This is autonomous new growth of tissue not regulated by external signal is the definition given by Ewing's. Now, Willis definition, which is in vogue and is most common and holds today, the neoplasm is abnormal mass of tissue, the growth of which is progressive, purposeless, invasive, irregular, excessive, and is uncoordinated with that of the normal tissue and persists even after the cessation of a stimuli which evoke the change. That is, Willis definition is common, and abnormal mass of tissue, the growth of new tissue, abnormal mass of new tissue or new growth, the growth of which is purposeless, progressive, purposeless, irregular, invasive, excessive, and is uncoordinated with that of normal tissue and persists in the same excessive manner after the cessation of a stimuli which evoke the change. This is the Willis definition which is in vogue. Then neoplasm, neoplasia, as I have told you, is an abnormal mass of tissue, the growth of which is excessive, irregular, invasive, progressive, purposeless. That is five adjectives: progressive, purposeless, irregular, invasive, excessive. The growth of which is uncoordinated with that of the normal tissue, and that neoplasm persists in the same excessive manner after the cessation of the stimuli which evoked the change. With the loss of responsiveness to normal growth control, and different from hyperplasia, metaplasia, and dysplasia. And the pathological process underlying the formation of neoplasm is called neoplasia. Now, the classification of neoplasms, the taxonomy and nomenclature, various classifications are proposed from time to time. amongst them are etiological classification, embryogenic classification, morphological classification, naked eye classification, functional classification, histogenetic classification, histologic classification, behavioral classification, and currently used classification. These are the eight categories of the classification occurring from time to time. Now coming to etiological classification. The etiological classification is based on etiology of the tumor. The etiology is a common practice for classifying pathological process of the disease, but it is impractical for the tumor because cause of the most tumor is unknown. The same etiological factor produce different types of the tumor. No single agent induced neoplasm, same agents produce tumors of several different types. So this definition is not continued, no longer continued. The second embryonic classification or embryogenic classification, at one time it was believed that most neoplasms derived from embryonic cells or cells that has reverted to embryonic state. The suffix oma, blastoma, was used for embryonic cells, like nephroblastoma in the kidney, retinoblastoma in case of retina, adrenoblastoma, that is neuroblastoma in the adrenal, or adrenoblastoma, hepatoblastoma in the liver, malignant cells, tumors of the liver childhood. So blastomas exist for embryonic tissue, nephroblastoma in the kidney, neuroblastoma in the adult, retinoblastoma in the retina, then hepatoblastoma for the liver. This was the embryonic classification. Third is naked eye or morphological classification, like pungating. Cauliflower like growth is pungating neoplasm. Annular, that is round coin like neoplasm, is called annular growth. Then squamous hard growth is called squamous carcinoma. Then medullary or encephaloid, that is soft brain like growth, is called medullary or encephaloid growth. Then mucoid, mucus secretion or mucoid growth. And signet, ring type of growth, that is nagdar unthi. जैसे रिंग में एक पीसेस ऑफ स्टोन लगा रहता है वन साइड में, तो सिग्नेट रिंग मीन्स द रिंग विथ ए स्टोन एट वन साइड, सिग्नेट रिंग. इट इज कॉमन इन GIT ट्यूमर, सिग्नेट रिंग अपीयरेंस ऑफ द ट्यूमर. सो दिस ऑल ऑर्गन कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए वैरायटी ऑफ टिश्यू, एंड ईच ऑफ दिस टिश्यू कैपेबल टू गिव one or more type of tumors, and tumor arising from different tissues of the same organ tend to behave differently. So this classification, naked morphological classification, was untenable. Then coming to functional classification, many tumors produce various substances in excess and named accordingly, like insulinoma that produces insulin, glucagonoma that produces glucagon, then mucoid producing mucin or mucoid like material, carcinoid tumor producing 5-hydroxytryptamine or serotonin, histamine. So these are according to the secretory substance the tumors are named, like insulinoma, glucagonoma, mucoid, carcinoid. But it is not satisfactory because materials may be formed by many different type of tumor. Same material may be formed by many different types of tumors. So this classification is also untenable. Now coming to histogenetic classification, cell of origin important in modern classification. Thus conventionally, body cell has been divided into epithelial cells and mesenchymal cells or connective tissue tube. Hence the tumor of the epithelial origin and tumor of the connective tissue origin. Six difficulties arise in this classification, that is nature of endothelium, mesothelium and synovium is not known. Then undifferentiated tumors, it is requires electron microscopy or immunohistochemistry for diagnosis. In tumor metaplasia, debatable origin of the tumors and origin of highly specialized tumors like of the nervous system, that is included in connective tissue, like malignant melanoma, leukemia, pheochromocytoma, glaucoma, gliomas. Origin of the embryogenic tissue, like germ cells, retinoblastoma, neuroblastoma and placental tissue. So this histogenetic classification has some importance, that is tumors of epithelium, tumors of the connective tissue origin. But it is also not generalized. It has some significance, that is for differentiating tumors of the epithelium and tumors of the connective tissue. Histologic classification used when the tumor is undifferentiated as to defy recognition of its site of origin, like glandular tissue, may be polygonal, spheroidal or anaplastic, small cells, large cells, pleomorphic cells, giant cells and spindle subcells. Occurrence of the tumor, metaplasia, histologic classification used in the occurrence of metaplasia and useful in histologic grading based on degree of differentiation, degree of irregularity and degree of number of mitoses. Then behavioral classification, two classical groups, benign or innocent group and second is malignant or cancer group. Difficulty arise in intermediate types of behavior that do not fall into either of the above categories, like osteoclastoma, basal cell carcinoma, choriocarcinoma, etc. Then latent cancer and carcinoma in situ, that is cytological features of the malignancy. There is a spontaneous regression also, so that cannot be categorized in the behavior group. And a spontaneous regression, that is complete removal or regression of the tumor, occurs in certain tumors like malignant melanoma, clear cell carcinoma of the kidney, neuroblastoma, choriocarcinoma, then Burkitt's lymphoma and regression of metastasis. These sometimes a note are asked on the stem in the Viva question, tell me some tumors which are regressed spontaneously. So the six examples of the tumors, there is a spontaneous regression like malignant melanoma, clear cell carcinoma, neuroblastoma, choriocarcinoma, Burkitt lymphoma and regression of metastasis. And this difficulty arises also in dormant tumors also in behavior classification. So currently used classification based on combination of two approaches, histogenetic tissue of origin like epithelial tissue or connective tissue of origin. Behavioral classification into benign tissue or malignant tumor, supplemented by histologic description. Suffix oma denotes tumor like papilloma, fibroma, adenoma, carcinoma, sarcoma. So suffix oma is used in case of tumor. Unfortunately, non-neoplastic swelling also have OMA terminology like hematoma, granuloma and hamartoma. Thus, malignant tumors of epithelium is called carcinoma and malignant tumors of connective tissue are called sarcoma. So, these tumors are named and classified on the site, regions or organs, histogenetic basis like epithelial origin or connective tissue origin, biological behavior, innocent or benign or malignant or cancerous. Then additional appropriate suffix oma and appended by histologic description of the tumor. Now classification of the tumor, this is a very exhaustive classification taken from the your general pathology textbook of general pathology by Walter and Israel. This has categorized epithelial tumors, connective tissue tumors, epithelial tumors, benign, intermediate, malignant. Epithelial tumor, benign, squamous cell papilloma, basal cell carcinoma, and squamous cell carcinoma, malignant, rank malignancy. These are locally malignant basal cell carcinoma, intermediate group. Then transitional cell papilloma, transitional cell carcinoma. Similarly, columnar cells, that is adenoma and adenocarcinoma. Then compact tissue, adenoma, adenocarcinoma. Then if there is cyst formation, it is called cyst adenoma. The malignant counterpart is called cyst adenocarcinoma. Then connective tissue, fibrous tissue, fibroma, adipose tissue, lycoma, malignant counterpart of fibrosarcoma, liposarcoma, then smooth muscle, leiomyoma, the malignant counterpart is called leiomyosarcoma, the striated muscles, rhabdomyoma, the malignant counterpart is called rhabdomyosarcoma. Then synovium, synovioma, malignant synovioma. Then cartilage, chondroma, chondrosarcoma. Bone, osteoma, osteogenic sarcoma. And there is intermediate category, that is giant cell tumors, locally aggressive, invasive. Then blood vessels, hemangioma, hemangiosarcoma, oringiosarcoma. Then mesothelium, benign mesothelioma, malignant mesothelioma. Meninges, meningioma, malignant meningioma. Then specialized tissue, neuroglion, ependyma, astrocytoma. And ependymoma, malignant counterpart. Chromaffin cells, carotid tumors, and malignant lymphoma. Then lymphoid tissue, pseudolymphoma, for example of the rectum and skin. The malignant counterpart are Hodgkin's disease, malignant lymphoma, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, leukemia, myeloproliferative, multiple myeloma, and malignant melanoma, melanocytes. Benign counterpart is called nevus, and malignant melanocytes, benign counterpart is called nevus, it is not given there. And malignant counterpart is called malignant melanoma. Benign melanoma is called nevus. Then continuation, trophoblast, hierarchy, fall, choriocarcinoma, destituents, invasive mole, intermediate, and malignant choriocarcinoma. Then germ cells, totipotent cells are called benign teratoma, malignant counterpart is called malignant teratoma. Then embryogenic cells, liver, kidney, nephroblastoma, hepatoblastoma. Unipotent cells are called retinoblastoma, medulloblastoma, hindbrain. Then sympathetic ganglia, ganglio, neuroma, and neuroblastoma. Embryonic vestiges, ameloblastoma, chordoma, notochord. Then brachial cells, bronchogenic carcinoma. Hematoma are malignant melanoma, chondrosarcoma, neurofibrosoma, sarcoma. Then tuberosus sclerosis, glioma, and malignant glioma. This is classification taken from your Hasmonas textbooks. That is tumor of one parenchymal type, epithelial type, papilloma, carcinoma, stromal cell, transitional cell, glandular adenocarcinoma, adenoma. Then nevus, benign, malignant melanocarcinoma or malignant melanoma. Hepatocytes, liver cell adenoma, and hepatocellular carcinoma or hepatoma. Placental hierarchy for mole and choriocarcinoma. Non-epithelial adipose tissue, lipoma, liposarcoma, fibrous tissue, fibroma, fibrosarcoma, then cartilage, chondroma, chondrosarcoma, bone, osteoma, osteogenic sarcoma, etc. Mixed tumor, salivary gland, pleomorphic adenoma, malignant mixed salivary tumors, and tumors of more than one germ cells, that is mature teratoma, benign teratoma also called, and immature teratoma, it is called malignant teratoma also, totipotent cells. This is taken from the Robbins. Same tumor of mesenchymal, tumor of the epithelial origins are there, nothing to say. Two system of classification. Walter Israel pathology textbook classification is standard, benign, intermediate, and malignant. Then tumor of mixed differentiation, mixed tumor, pleomorphic adenoma of the salivary gland. Then teratoma comprised of more than one germ cells and arise from totipotent cells. And aberrant differentiation, hematoma. Hematoma are tumor-like developmental malformation composed of tissues indigenous to the part but lacking the growth potential of the true neoplasm. Hematoma, example are hemangioma, tuberosus sclerosis are examples of malignant melanoma, nevus are example of hematoma. Hematoma are, this is important, hematoma you will encounter in various sites. Hematoma is developmental tumor-like malformation. Consisting of tissue indigenous to the part, developmental tumor-like malformation consisting of tissue indigenous to the part but lacking the growth potential of true neoplasm, like your nevus or malignant melanoma, tuberous sclerosis, hemangioma are example of hematoma. Then choriostoma are ectopic focus of normal tissue like heterotopia. Then misnomer, hepatoma is malignant tumor, liver tumor, melanoma, malignant tumor of the melanocytic cells, seminoma, malignant testicular tumor,
and lymphoma, malignant tumor of the lymphocytes. Neoplasia. The neoplasia, all tumors have two basic components, parenchyma and stroma. The parenchyma made up of neoplastic cells and stroma made up of non-neoplastic host-derived connective tissue and blood vessels cells. The parenchyma determines the biologic behavior of the tumor from which the tumor derives its name. And stroma carries the blood supply, provides support for the growth of the parenchyma. This is benign and malignant tumor. You should know the difference between behavioral classification. I have told innocent or benign and malignant or cancerous. In the benign tumor or malignant tumor, clinical diagnosis, boundaries encapsulated poorly. This is a circumscribed surrounding tissue, compressed, invaded, size small, larger. Then secondary changes like hemorrhage, necrosis, it is uncommon in benign, it is common in malignant tumor. Then pattern, the features of aplasia are there, I will discuss later on. Then growth rate is slow, in case of benign it is rapid, in case of malignant. So growth rate and mode of growth, it is expansile, in case of benign tumor it is invasive, in case of malignant tumor. Then metastasis, it is absent in benign tumor, it is frequent or recurrent, it is frequent in case of malignant tumor. Then prognosis, local complication better in benign tumor and it is worse in malignant tumor. Death occurs by local and metastatic complications. Clinical difference, benign and malignant. Benign tumor, left side, right side, benign tumor, left side, right side is malignant tumor. Clinical difference, rate of growth, grows slowly, grows rapidly. Mode of growth, expansive growth, invasive growth. Fixity, that is fixation to the underlying tissue, so it is not movable. So fixity is absent in benign, it is present in malignant tissue. Usually benign tumors are encapsulated, surrounded by capsules, and it is uncapsulated or not capsulated in malignant tumors. They do not recur after removal. Recurrence is there in malignant tissue. So they do not metastasize. Metastasis is a feature in malignant tissue. They not kill the tissue unless compress the vital organs. Malignant tumors usually kill the tissue. Then rarely show metastasis, often show necrosis and ulceration. Cachexia, no cachexia. Cachexia and anemia is there in case of malignant tumor. Age of occurrence, the malignant benign tumors occurs in younger age, less than 40, it occurs in older age, more than 50 to 60. This is anaplasia, lack of differentiation, basal polarity, loss of basal polarity, loss of basal polarity. Then no pleomorphism in normal tissue, pleomorphism is there. Nuclear cytoplasmic ratio is normal, it is increased. Nucleus ratio, nucleic acid synthesis is more, so increased nuclear cytoplasmic ratio. No anisotropy, bigger nucleus, nucleolus, so anisonucleosis. No nuclear chromatin, normal, it is hyperchromatic nuclear. Hyperchromatism, nucleoli normal, nucleoli prominent. Mitotic figures are normal or absent, it is abnormal and increased and abnormal mitotic figures. No giant cells, here tumor giant cells are present. Cytoplasm is normal, cytoplasmic inclusions are there. Chromosomal diploidy, here it is aneuploidy. Then nuclear criteria of malignancy. It is given in the Hasmon textbook in the last few chapters, diagnostic cytopathology, from which it has been taken. Nuclear size, larger, benign. Variation in size, anisonucleosis is significant. Nuclear cytoplasmic ratio increased. Nuclear shape, moderate to marked variation, pleomorphism. Nuclear membrane, irregular thickening, angulation and indentation. Nuclear chromatic, hyperchromatic nuclei in malignant. Nucleoli, increased size and number. Then number of nucleoli, multinucleation, unreliable nuclear character is more important. Mitosis, increased and abnormal mitosis like tripolar mitosis, quadripolar mitosis, asymmetrical mitosis, etc. Then cytoplasmic criteria of malignancy. A scant cytoplasm, abnormal maturation and differentiation, abnormal vacuolation in the cytoplasm, normal cytoplasmic elements decreased or lost, like mitochondria is decreased in number, ribosome free is increased, but bound ribosome are reduced in number, then endoplasmic reticulum are decreased in number, there is acidophilia or eosinophilia, redness of the cytoplasm. Cytoplasmic inclusions may be present like mucin and Schwann cell carcinoma, melanin in melanoma and basal cell carcinoma, and glycogen and lipids in clear cell carcinoma of the kidney. So some difference between the carcinoma and sarcoma. The benign tumor of the epithelial origin, malignant tumor of the epithelial origin is called carcinoma, and malignant tumor of the connective tissue or mesenchymal origin is called sarcoma. Both carcinoma and sarcoma are malignant tumors. Carcinoma arise from epithelial tissue, sarcoma arise from mesenchymal tissue. Carcinoma is more common than sarcoma. Then carcinoma affect older people, while sarcoma usually affect younger people. Carcinoma is spread differently by hematogenous lymphatic spread. Sarcoma is spread by hematogenous route. The carcinoma and sarcoma origin epithelium connective tissue behavior benign, malignant, both are malignant. Frequency, carcinoma more common, sarcoma rare. Preferred route of metastasis, lymph node or lymphatic channel, hematogenous or bone by a blood borne. In C2 phase, carcinoma is there, no C2 phase in sarcoma. Age groups usually less than 50, it is more than 50 in carcinoma, and it is less than 50 in case of sarcoma. Then growth rate is rapid, it is slower in sarcoma. Then response to chemotherapy more in carcinoma, less in sarcoma. Most common type anywhere, and sarcoma occurs in the bone, liver and lungs. Same difference, cell of origin epithelial, mesenchymal, cellular arrangement, alveolar, granular, singly. Size less in size, more in size sarcoma. Blood vessels less, more in sarcoma. Hemorrhages less, more in sarcoma. Necrosis less, more in sarcoma. Age incidence older, it is at some at younger age group less than 50. Mode of metastasis, lymphatic or lymph node, it is hematogenous. Site of metastasis, renal lymph nodes, it is to the lungs. So carcinoma, sarcoma again, origin epithelium, mesenchymal tissue, example squamous cell carcinoma, adenocarcinoma, osteosarcoma, chondrosarcoma, fibrosarcoma, liposarcoma. Behavior, both are malignant. Frequency, carcinoma more common, less. Growth rate slow, rapid in sarcoma. Metastasis route, lymphatic route in carcinoma, it is hematogenous route in sarcoma. In C2 phase is there in carcinoma, no C2 phase in sarcoma. Age group more than 50 in case of carcinoma, less than 50 in case of sarcoma. Often light microscopy, group of cells separated by connective tissue. Here in sarcoma, individual cells separated from adjacent tissue by connective tissue. Immunohistochemistry, the marker of immunochemical marker, histochemical marker are keratin for epithelial tissue, that is carcinoma, vimentin for case of sarcoma. Electron microscopy express desmosome. They do not express desmosomes, junctional complex. Prognosis relatively good in case of carcinoma, it is bad in case of sarcoma. This is the figure, squamous cell carcinoma. Carcinoma arising from epithelium blood, that is squamous differentiation are called squamous cell carcinoma. Here it is epithelial pearls, that is it is in the cell nest of abnormal atypical squamous epithelium. Cell nest is characteristic of differentiated squamous cell carcinoma. Again, this is the cell nest is there in squamous cell carcinoma. From epidermis, there is invasion into underlying tissue, the abnormal cells, discontinuous is the epithelium, here the cell nest or epithelial pearl, it is also called epithelial pearl in case of squamous cell carcinoma. Here adrenocortical carcinoma arising from the adrenocortical gland, and it is osteogenic sarcoma arising from the bone, osteogenic sarcoma, Mutton's leg appearance. Here osteoid formation is there, this is osteoid lying in case of osteogenic sarcoma, osteoid lying is there in case of sarcoma, osteogenic sarcoma. This is benign tumor of the adipose tissue, lipoma, and it is malignant tumor of the adipose tissue, that is the nucleus is increased, hyperchromatic, dark colored, hyperchromatic, abnormal mitosis is there. So this is the liposarcoma. This is the liposarcoma again. exuberant growth of the hyperchromatic nuclei in the individual cells. So liposarcoma, lipoma benign, it is counterpart mesenchymal tumor, adipose tissue, liposarcoma. Similarly, benign of the osteogenic tissue is osteoma and it is osteogenic sarcoma. Thank you. This is all about the introduction of the tumor, that is classification of the tumors, difference between benign tumor, malignant tumor, difference between carcinoma and difference between the sarcoma. Thank you.